Hi all. In this video, let's learn about some of the VS Code extensions for the web and React developers, which will improve our productivity. So let's start with the React snippet. So while you're writing a React code, the most of the code we write, we import the React, we use useState, use effect like that. So instead of writing this repeated times again and again, what if you have any of the shortcuts where it will be providing any of the snippet so that you no need to write them, it will be generated automatically. So let's see that. Yeah, in the VS Code, go to the extensions in the left side and type React snippet. So the first one, when you type the in the extensions React snippet, so download this ES7 React Redux GraphQL thing. So if you install this extension and if needed, reload the VS Code, then once coming back to our file, if you type IMR, so it has provided me a list of suggestions for the import statements. I can type IMRE so that it will import React and use effect as well. So instead of writing this manually, it is very much easy, right? So if you type just IMR or IMR something like that, it would be imported automatically. Also, we have most of the time we'll be using state in our application. Instead of writing its syntax, you may use like this, use state. So if I type this and enter, it has provided me the default syntax for us. You no need to type everything. Just you can modify the variable names and you can proceed. So in a similar way, if you're going to use effect, so you can see here, use effect, just type something. The auto session will be coming so that you can select whatever function you want. So use effect. As soon as I select the use effect, it has given me the default syntax of the use effect with the return cleanup method and the dependency input and also the callback function. So in this way, in these React snippets, like this helps us a lot to improve the productivity. So instead of writing the dump code again and again, you can use this extension so that you can speed up your work. Coming to the second one is like auto imports. The problem with the auto imports is like the import statements is, if you want to use any of the component, you need to import that component in the other component. So while you are importing, there would be two problems. One would be the typo issues, like if you not give the exact import statement component name, that would be some of the typo issues. And the second thing is like you need to remember or you need to give the exact path of the component which you are importing. So these two are some of the part which takes more time while you are working. So what if you have an autocomplete where if you click whatever component you are using, if you use that, what if it auto imports that component? It helps us a lot, right? So how to do that? For that, go to the files, preferences, settings. So in the settings, just type auto import. So if you type auto import, you'll be getting an option like this, JavaScript suggestion auto import. Just enable this one. Once if you enable this, so you can use this auto import statements. So how to use this? So I am coming to a random one component and I wanted to import another component where I will try to do like this. So I will do like a greeter. Okay. So if I do this, it would be automatically imported. So I guess I have removed that. So that's the reason. Let me check it once again. So when you want to, yes, when you want to do a welcome component import, see, I have just typed the welcome and I'm clicking enter. So if you see, the import statement was automatically, it came, right? So in this way, you can use this automatically imports so that you can improve your productivity. Fine, coming to the third part, I mean, third settings or extension is like, you have an unused imports. Like here, you have not used welcome component, sample component, and logo image as well. In your import statements, in your component, there might be 10 or 5 to 6 components. So instead of going here and manually deleting them one by one, you can do this automatically. Like if you want this unused imports to be removed and these imports can be organized in an order, then you have a setting like go to view. This is not a setting, like you can do it whenever in the file you are. So go to view and command palette. Here type organize imports. If you type this organize imports, shortcut would be shift alt O. Okay, I'm clicking this. Okay, if I click this, did you observe the welcome unused imports are removed? And the existing imports would be organized in an alphabetical order, which will help us a lot. For example, with the shortcut, it would be help us a lot, like Shift Alt O. See, this is a very simple one. All the unused imports would be removed from our application, by which we can improve our productivity as well as the linting issues as well. Most of our linting issues will come with this unused things, right? So just by clicking Shift Alt O, you can write off this ES lint issues. The fourth one is emit. So most of the React developers would be working on the JSX code, where they need to open the tag and they need to end the tags as well. So we need to use emit. Most of them are aware of this emit, I guess. So what this emit is, like if I open any div, and if I close this automatically, the closing div tag is came. So this is an emit. So once you open the code tag, it will automatically close this tag. This is about emit. So how to use this? Like, let me show that settings as well. So go to the file preferences. If this is a Mac, then you need to go to the code. Here you will be having some code option where you will be having the preferences and here in the preferences settings, you can go and you can click emit. Yep, the emit, you can click the emit option where, let me show you. Yep, here in this emit option, you can add an option like this. So they ask us to provide the values like JavaScript and JavaScript React. So if you provide an include language like this, okay, and I'm clicking OK. From next onwards, you can the JSX syntax will be understanding our syntax, and it would be automatically close the all the tags. This will increase our productivity in terms of closing the tags. And if there is any mismatch in the tags also, it will help us a lot. So coming to the fifth part is prettier. So we know this prettier is it will format the code. For example, the code is not in a formatted way. So if the code is in this format, and which will not be in a readable format. If you click save, Control S, so it was formatted automatically. To do this, we need to install the prettier extension. So let me do that. So we need to do prettier. So type this prettier. So you'll be getting the first one. So you can install that. So I have installed that. So it is showing me as uninstall. So once you install that prettier, so then you need to do one setting, because it should work. Prettier should work when you save the file, then the code would be automatically formatted. So to do that setting, once you have installed Prettier, go to the file preferences settings. Here you need to do format on save. Just I'm typing format on save. So if you click this, if you check this one, so whenever you save the file, then the Prettier would be executed, and it will save format our code accordingly. So here the prettier is added. So that's the reason it will prettify our code in a readable format. So instead of doing this readability or adding the indentations manually, this prettier extension helps us a lot in formatting the code on save. So these are some of the extensions, VS Code extensions, which may help you to improve the productivity. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for the more videos.